Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah.
I think Allah sent me a sign at this time, but I didn't notice.
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. MashaAllah. Tabarakallah. Why accept Islam? Jai Kim, yani Daud Kim. Isliye Islam ko accept kiya hai? Kya karam hai? Kyun hidayat mila hai? Assalamu alaikum dosto, kaise ho aap sab log? Umeed hai ki khairiyat se honge aur main alhamdulillah Allah ki meherbani se dosto bahut acha ho. Dosto main hu Kabir Ahmed aur aap log dekh rahe ho my YouTube channel Kabir Reaction. Dosto agar aap log ne abhi tak subscribe nahi kiya hai to der kis baat ka hai, jaldi se subscribe kar lena, bell icon ko press karna na bhule, aur apka pyara sa haath se video pe ek like zarur kar dena. Aur dosto jo log ne subscribe kiya hai aap log ka bahut bahut shukriya hai. आप लोगों का प्यार देने के लिए आपका प्यार मेरे लिए बहुत जरूरी है. और दोस्तों वीडियो को शेयर करना ना भूले. दोस्तों दाऊद किम, जिसका नाम था पहले जय किम, क्यों इस्लाम कबूल किया है, क्या मजबूरी था? आज दाऊद किम खुद बताने वाला है कि उनको कैसे इस्लाम के साथ मुलाकात हुआ था, कहां पर हुआ था और क्यों हुआ था, किसके कारण हुआ था, और आज वो कैसे है और इस्लाम को लेकर कितना प्राउड फील कर रहा है, या फिर और इस्लाम को लेकर परेशानी में है, और उनका फैमिली उनको क्या कहते हैं, उनका फ्रेंड क्या कहते हैं, सब कुछ वो बताने वाला है. तो वीडियो को दोस्तों जरूर देखना, स्किप मत करना, क्योंकि इस वीडियो से बहुत शिक्षा मिलने वाला है. आइए चलिए दोस्तों वीडियो को शुरू करता हूँ.
I didn't know about Islam at that time, so I even didn't know that there were so many Muslim people in Indonesia. I really didn't know that. Actually, two things made me so surprised. First, they were really kind than I expected, and second is that so many girls are covering their faces with veils. I didn't even know the word hijab, and you know, Indonesia is really a hot country, so I was so curious, so I asked the girl who wears hijab, why are you wearing a scarf on your face? Did someone force you? And he said, I'm a diamond, incredibly precious. So I don't want to show this to other people. Nobody forced me. This is my choice, and I'm so proud of it. At the moment, I was really shocked. I thought that was oppression, but they were really proud of this. Yeah, it was really interesting. What made her so proud? At that time, I didn't know it was the face. I think Allah sent me a sign at this time, but I didn't notice. I came back to Korea, but my father lost his job suddenly, so I quit music and started work. I liked my job, but it was not easy because I wanted to do more creative things. So that's why I started YouTube. And randomly talked about the memories about Muslim in Indonesia. And suddenly, so many people watched that video. And that was my second meeting with Islam. I didn't notice the first time, but this time it was different. It's related to my situation. Okay, I'll tell you. I couldn't tell anyone, but actually I was having a hard time. Because my goal of my life was music. But I should quit. So I lost my motivation of life. I wanted to go the next step, but I don't know how. I was totally lost. There was no peace in my mind. But surprisingly, At that time, it gave me a chance to meet Islam. Through this, I could meet many Muslims, revered Muslims, not in the media. So I got along with them and found out what I didn't know about Islam. Why do they believe in Allah? Why do they pray? Why don't they eat pork? Why don't they drink? And what is halal? And what is haram? And who is Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, many things. I learned one by one. And I found something really special I never felt before. It's very hard to explain, but I felt they have something that I'm missing. Because the way they treat their lives is definitely different from mine. I thought life is competition, and only surviving the competition is success. I thought I have to fight and win, but they were different. They always had others, and they were always thankful for what was given for them. This impressed me a lot, the attitude of their life. My Muslim friend told me life is a journey, not a competition. And the purpose of this journey is to go on the right path according to God. Allah, the most glorified and the most high. If you follow Allah on the right path, there will be a great present at the end of this journey. Yeah, that's Jannah, the paradise. When I heard this, I felt like someone punched my face so hard. The belief that you're going to the right path. It touched and moved my heart. In the beginning and the end of this everything, there. Was Allah. This was the something I was looking for. So to know about this, I started to follow their practice. I read the Quran, studied about Muhammad, peace be upon him. I fasted for a month in Ramadan. I went to mosque and prayed. It happened in just a few months. As I experienced their practice little by little, my faith also grew up. The faith in Allah who created me and also guided me. The absolute, the most gracious and most merciful. And these things never happened in one time. I found it little by little, and the important thing is I found it myself. Nobody forced me. As I fasted, I found gratitude for Allah and found that prayer to Allah would give me the peace of mind. So finally, I was sure about my belief. So I thought about becoming a Muslim. But nevertheless, I hesitated for a long time. There are reasons. Many people told me that the poor and uncle, but I didn't think it's not very difficult if I have faith. There were other reasons. First, can I overcome the prejudice of others as a Muslim? And second, am I perfectly prepared to be a Muslim? And also a position for my family. For me, it was a big problem and pressure. I pressed myself a lot. But after that, I thought like this. Why am I pressing myself? Islam is a religion that creates a relationship between me. And Allah, not others. If Allah made a plan for me, only Allah can give me the answer. So I visited the mosque and asked him. What do I have to do? And surprisingly, my thoughts organized. I got a conclusion. I have faith and will to practice. So I don't need to hesitate anymore. I don't need to care about other people's opinion. Because my life is mine, not others. My relationship with Allah is only mine. They can't take the responsibility about my life. Even my mom and dad, of course I love mom and dad. And one more thing about the perfect patient. There's no perfect human. There's no perfect thing except Allah. But can't be a Muslim because I'm afraid of the mistakes I'll make in the future. I think this is an excuse for myself. Of course I'll make a mistake because I'm not perfect. Already I had a lot of mistakes. But I believe he will lead me back in the right way. As he led me here. I'm in his plan. So I know he helps me. So that's why I decide and revert. That's my story. So now I'm Daud. And I'm so proud of that. I was sailing alone on a small boat over a dark and huge sea. I was sinking without knowing where to go. But the merciful Allah recognized and signaled me. And fortunately, I noticed and catched it. And finally, I knew that following Allah is the purpose of this journey. So now I know where I have to go. He gave me the light. And I believe that is the greatest blessing and gift in my life. So I'm like a baby Muslim who doesn't know anything well yet. But I will try to be a good Muslim, little by little. So nice to meet you, brothers and sisters. I'm so happy to meet you as a Muslim. I've talked a lot this word, but finally, I can tell you from my heart. Assalamu alaikum. There's no God but Allah, and Muhammad is his messenger.
Allahu Akbar. Dosto 9/11. 9/11 ने क्या किया दोस्तों? 9/11 के कारण दुनिया में बहुत सारे लोगों को पता नहीं था कि इस्लाम क्या है, मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम कौन है, कुरान करीम क्या है। लेकिन 9/11 के बाद ये लोग ने रिसर्च करना चालू किया कि मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम कौन है, कुरान क्या है, इस्लाम क्या है। और बहुत सारे लोगों ने इस्लाम को अपनाया था, इस्लाम को कबूल किया था, अल्लाह की तरफ से ये लोगों को हिदायत मिला है। लेकिन दाऊद किम भाई जो है उनका कहानी अलग है। उनको पहली बार पता चला 9/11 में कि इस्लाम एक धर्म है, लेकिन जब वो इंडोनेशिया में आए थे वो म्यूजिशियन थे और उसके कारण इंडोनेशिया में आए थे और इंडोनेशिया में देखा बहुत सारी लड़की लोग हिजाब पहनती है, हिजाब क्यों पहनती है, जब उन्होंने पूछा तो वह लोग ने कहा कि इस्लाम के बारे में कहा और कहा हम प्राउड फील करते हैं। जब उन्होंने पूछा कि कोई पेशार देता है क्या, उन्होंने वह लोग कहा कि नहीं, हम प्राउड फील करते हैं, हमारा दिल खुश होते हैं। तब उन्होंने डिस्कस चालू किया और उसके बाद अल्लाह की तरफ से उनको हिदायत मिला। तो दोस्तों, ये वीडियो से आप लोगों को क्या शिक्षा मिला है? दोस्तों, अगर इस्लाम टेररिस्ट होता था, जो लोग हमेशा कहते रहते कि इस्लाम आतंकवादी है, इस्लाम टेररिस्ट है, अगर ऐसा है तो ये लोग इस्लाम क्यों कबूल कर रहे हैं? दोस्तों, आज के दिन में इतना इंटेलिजेंट दुनिया है, आज के दिन में क्यों कबूल कर रहे हैं इस टेररिस्ट रिलीजन को, इस आतंकवादी धर्म को? तो दोस्तों, इसका मतलब है कि ये लोग चाहते हैं कि इस्लाम का जो चिराग है उसको दुनिया से मिटा देने का है। लेकिन अल्लाह क्या कहता है, इस चिराग को मिटाने वाला दुनिया में कोई ताकत पैदा नहीं हुआ है, क्योंकि ये अल्लाह की तरफ से आया है। लेकिन हमारा मुसलमान का भी कुछ गलतियां है। अगर हम मुसलमान नाम से आज रह गया है, इस्लाम का कोई कानून हमारा पास नहीं है, हम फॉलो नहीं करते। तो दोस्तों, वीडियो से क्या शिक्षा मिला है जरूर कमेंट करके बताना, और अल्लाह के पास यही दुआ है कि अल्लाह हम सबको हिदायत दे, इस्लाम ने जो रास्ता बताया, मोहम्मद सलाम का जो तरीका है, उस तरीका के मुताबिक चलने का तौफीक दे। दोस्तों, वीडियो को शेयर करना ना भूले, लाइक करना ना भूले, और चैनल पे नया हो तो दूसरे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कर देना इसी तरह का वीडियो पाने के लिए। चलिए दोस्तों, मिलते हो किसी और एक वीडियो को लेकर, तब तक के लिए अल्लाह हाफिज।